What's going on, beautiful people? Thank you for returning back to my channel, The Root Wave. In this episode, I have Fernando Michael of The Fox and King. Please say hello, sir. Let us know where we can find you, please.
How you doing? Fernando here. You can find The Fox and King on Instagram, on Facebook, at The Fox and King underscore Inc. Find all of our upcoming shows, all of our events, anything happening, you can find us all there. You can also learn more about the Underground, Underground FLC, All Ages Bronx Music at Instagram, Underground, and Facebook as well.
Thank you for being on the channel. You're someone from the Bronx that seems to be making some moves in the underground music scene, and I just wanted to get you on so that way we can talk a little bit about what that consists of, get the people informed in the area, and also just kind of follow your journey as far as what the hustle is to see if we can inspire other people to also do some things around here, right? So if you wouldn't mind just explaining a little bit more about what you do, please.
Sure. So I started The Fox and King when I was 18, really focusing on local music. You know, I grew up around going to local shows, underground shows, and, you know, it was an opportunity for kids to get involved, for the 14, 15-year-olds, you know, to go on a Friday night, see their friends on stage, hang out, you know, just really for the love of music. And it's just something I want to get into. You know, I fell in love with the industry, whether it was booking shows, working with musicians, artists. And, you know, over the years, I've been, you know, very blessed to work with a lot of festivals, Warped Tour, CMJ, South by Southwest. I've worked with a lot of great people. I've learned a lot. And right now with the Underground, we're just, you know, the Fox and King's bringing back this underground, basement, grungy, you know, scene that we used to have, that I used to have. You know, I remember 300-400 kids packed in on a Friday night, just for the love of music, to see touring bands, to see Bronx bands. And, you know, it's time that comes back. And that's what we're doing. And, you know, come October 18th, it's actually going to be 1 year that we started this. So I'm very excited for that. It's going to be a great time. And again, you know, what I do is my passion for music. I want to be involved in that as much as possible. I want to grow. I want to help others. And really just showcase what we have to offer, not only across New York City, across the world, but here in the Bronx especially. And that's what I care about.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. It's always good that to see someone actually like trying to put something together in the borough and then trying to make it succeed. It's something awesome that I think we all have to support. Tell us a little bit about how you got started. Like what got you to really, like what was the day that you said, like you said it has been a year, right? So what happened a year ago that made you just like kind of put it all together and started?
So the Underground started, we brought back the Underground scene about a year ago, and some close friends and I got together and said, you know what, we have the opportunity, we have the means, there's a need for this, why not just try to put it back together? And, you know, we've been working with the First Lutheran Church, who was the original venue, you know, many years ago for the Bronx Underground, and we spoke to them, they approved it, and we just kept that going. The same third Friday of the month. Bronx bands, local bands, and we really just want to rebuild it. And it's just, it's been phenomenal so far. But starting it was tricky. You know, it was definitely tricky. Like, can we do this today? Is there, you know, you have Fortnite, you have Netflix, you have people, like, how do you get kids out and see their friends on stage and check out all these bands that we have here that not too many people know of, but they should. But a year later, you know, we've had some really awesome shows. We've been blessed with some really awesome bands. A lot of awesome, you know, Jude Torres Trio, Enziguri, Duryea. Like, these are all just phenomenal Bronx artists. And it's been amazing. I started TFAC, the Fox and King, when I was 18. I was still in college. And I had the opportunity to assist with a local business, a cafe in the Bronx. And they had just opened, you know, they're looking to get the word out a little bit. And that's when I wanted to get into, booking shows, entertainment, all of that. I said, why not let me book your grand opening? That was my first ever show. It was called Coffee Shop Soundtrack is what I called it. And it just kicked off from there. Started booking, across the Bronx, Brooklyn, Manhattan. Got a dope internship, travel a little bit, and just hard work and perseverance.
What have you found it to be the most difficult in regards to getting all this accomplished?
I would say one of the most difficult things is time management. Balancing your hustle on the side. Maybe you have a day job, which I do. I do have a day job as well. And that's 8 hours a day, 5 days a week. But you still have to make that time to focus on all your other endeavors. Especially if this is a passion, if this is something you want to, do full time for the rest of your life, you need to make that time. Time management, again, that's the biggest thing. Work life, day job life, personal time, family time. It comes down to, like, there was a quote that I had read, to make this happen, to follow your passion and pursue your dreams, you have to live life in a way that most people won't, to live how most people can't. And that's really that whole mindset about that, sacrifice now to reap your rewards later.
No, that's true. I mean, it's the only way you get stuff to happen. I mean, we can wish it all you want, but if you're not putting the hustle behind it, it's not gonna happen.
Absolutely.
What has been the response by the, let's say, the artist to what you're trying to do?
So it's actually quite humbling. We've had such a great response from all of the artists that we've booked so far. Not only thanking us to bring back to for bringing back this scene, but also giving them a place to perform and play in their own borough. You go down to Brooklyn, you get onto Manhattan, you have all these venues, you have all these bars. Where do we go in the Bronx? Where can we go? What venue is out there, in the Bronx that we could all gather, not only for all ages, but in general? Again, First Lutheran Church, where we hold our shows there. It's an amazing spot. There's a kitchen, you have the entire stage, you have lights. It's gorgeous. It's absolutely great. And the artists have been, nothing short of grateful. It's really fantastic. We had our last show. We had a couple bands from, I think we had one from Connecticut, Brooklyn, Jersey, and they're all coming here, to our hood to play, and it's fantastic. And we can't wait to come back again. Thank you so much. We had such a great time. That's what I live for. If people are having a good time, the artists are happy, the crowd's bumping. Couldn't be more happy.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. It's really awesome to be able to create something like that and actually get people to respond and actually join in and actually participate and all that. Where do you see the underground scene overall being in the next 3 to 5 years?
I can only hope that we find one. I feel like we have. I feel like we would need a more permanent space. I want to have that. I want to have an entire house, for the underground, for the Fox and King. I want the scene to grow and more kids to be inspired to create bands, to get back into music. I just want the entire borough to be imbued, with just local music. Local community, music lessons here. I'm looking for. I just want it to be a hub for local music in the Bronx, and to get to that point, it's hard. There's a lot of time, there's a lot of work and effort put into that, but that's where I see this going, and I hope I could be one of the people along with everyone else to help build this scene up.
What would you for the people who are watching this, what would you ask them in regards to help for your movement or for your projects? Like what could you ask them in return?
Awareness, I think, is the most important thing. I was talking to a friend of mine who about music in the Bronx and music in New York City in general, and they were surprised that there was rock music in the Bronx. There was what we're doing, because we're primarily located, around Pelham on the 6 Line, Throgs Neck, and they were like, "Oh, you guys are doing stuff over there? There's something going on." So having that awareness, having that extra promotion to what we're doing, and sharing, okay, there is a music scene in the Bronx, you know, there is this, there is that. Just get the word out there. You know, get the word out there. If we could get bands coming in from Brooklyn, Jersey, Connecticut, you know, we have that movement happening. And I want to keep that here in the Bronx. And just spread the word. You know, if anything, you know, share a flyer, share a link. It costs $0 to, you know, share something on your friend's page or anything like that. It's all just for the love of music.
What has been, well, you mentioned that you do a lot of rock. Is rock the only genre you're into, or is that just mainly?
So me personally, I grew up with a lot of reggae, ska, rock. Like that's my base. I do love all kinds of music, and we are looking to expand with the underground as well. Eventually, we'll have, you know, different kinds of, you know, genre nights or anything like that, or mixing all the genres together. We had a really dope artist, Zai, amazing rapper, phenomenal artist, and he was performing with live backing. Danny from the Juju Boys Trio, I think, was there. Durier was providing guitar. That collaboration between genres, you know, that love for just performing, it goes beyond genre, you know. But we definitely want to expand for sure.
So what's the next step for you in your project with the Fox and King? What's next?
So we actually very excited. Come the 18th, we're going to be launching our first merch line. So we have a bunch of shirts, right? We have a bunch of shirts and other little items like that. And I've been doing this for almost 8 years, and so I'm very excited to have this. You know, now it's something I can give out. You know, all of that stuff. We're actually dropping underground shirts as well, which we'll have out at the 18th show. And right now, the Fox and King, we're doing a lot of shows. We have this series with the Underground. We have shows in Westchester now. We're going to be booking back in Manhattan. The Fox and King is really a culmination of my passion for music. Excuse me. And it's something I want to develop. I want it, you know, I'd love to have three shows in one night, you know, Bronx, Westchester, Manhattan. It's just, I just love working with music. You know, I love going on tour. I love working with artists, and I want to expand on that. And, you know, with this merch line, with the Bronx series that we're doing, taking it back home, I just hope more people hear about us and, you know, connect, network. If I could help anyone, you know, with music or anything like that, I'd love to. And let's just develop and grow.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. What advice would you give someone who might watch this and actually wants to start performing and building their talent? What would you advise them in regards to getting out there and performing and all that stuff?
I would, you know, perform, practice your music, rehearse every single day. Every single day. If you have a show coming up, blast it everywhere. And don't stick to one, like, don't just stick to Instagram. Stick to all of your social medias. Share your flyers. Connect with other artists. You know, there's tons of resources out there, especially on Facebook. There's tons of local music, Artist Connect, New York City artists. Intertwine with them. You know, go to other people's shows. Show that support. Build your brand. You know, that's something I feel like people also forget. Yes, your music is, you know, your core tool, your core passion, but build the brand around yourself. I think that's the most important. If you have your mold around your practice, then you're good. You're gonna go much further than most people think you are. But really, it's keeping that hustle. It's keeping that hustle, and that's really it, you know.
Yeah, no, I appreciate that. Before I let you go, though, let us know one more time where we can find you, please.
Absolutely. You could find the Fox and King on Facebook, Instagram, anywhere really. We even have our own Spotify playlist of Bronx artists that you could find. But Instagram, the Fox and King underscore Inc. And you could find the Underground as well, the Underground FOC on Instagram and Facebook. And you know, we hope to see you out October 18th, the Underground's 1 year anniversary show. We have a stacked lineup. It's going to be fantastic. We have artists as well coming in. And then we also have an after party at Jimmy Ryan's with more bands. So it's going to be fantastic.
Very awesome. And I hope to see you there because I'll be there.
Oh, thank you so much,
Yeah,
man.
for real.
Thank you.
And then, all right, so before I go, I'm just going to have you just leave us with some type of positive reinforcement, something that'll just maybe somebody that's watching that may want to get into the music scene, either behind the scenes or just performing or anything that may inspire someone to just get up and actually do something for themselves, like you are, like I am,
Absolutely.
please.
I think it's important, like I said, I have a day job and it could be grueling, 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, doing something you don't want to do, but it's that tool to get you where you want to be. But once you leave work, once you get out, once you have that time, focus on yourself, build upon yourself, follow your dream. As corny as that may sound, if it's going to bring you happiness, then do it. If it's gonna, bring you peace, then do it. That's really what it is at the end of the day. Music gives me peace, and this is what I want for the rest of my life.
Awesome. Awesome. Thank you, Fernando. I really appreciate it. I'm going to make sure I put all this stuff on the screen, including the flyer for your event that I'll be at also on October 18th.
Absolutely.
And we'll release that interview before then, so that way people can hear it and then maybe show up. I think that's it. I really appreciate you. Thank you so much. I like what you're doing for the Bronx. Thank you for helping me out also the other day. I appreciate that. We're all helping each other. And to my audience, please go support Fernando, also the Fox and King. I'm going to have all the information on the screen so that way you can follow it. I appreciate it, and I'll catch you around on the next episode. Peace. Later, Fernando.
Right, man. Thank you.